Taylor, you are you're known for your civil rights background, and you've written so much about injustice on a number of different levels. And this is the approach you took while researching the shame of college sports for the Atlantic magazine. And you already have received so much feedback. If you don't mind, what we were just talking about in the break, because I think it's fascinating. A lot of people angry about this article. How are you taking that, and what is that telling you?
Well, I'm a little shell-shocked. People, they just released it online yesterday. People care about it an awful lot. It's like sports. It engages great passion. We're the only country in the world that hosts big money sports in universities and colleges. And so we have this clash there between whether colleges should be about education and thought or whether they should be about entertainment for all of us. And it really does arouse a lot of passion.
And you know what? I pulled out a couple things that I'm guessing this is what aroused a lot of passion and I guess, you know, fire about this article. You lay out what you describe a plantation mentality in your article. You know, you write about the least educated being the most exploited. Talk to me about that.
Well, college sports uniquely has a multi-million, really multi-billion dollar industry whose one rule is that the people who generate most of the income cannot share in it. That's not by law. You could not write a law to deny these people the revenue that they earn. It's by conspiracy and by custom. We call it amateurism. And therefore, these college athletes, I'm not saying colleges should have to pay players. I'm just saying the system now where they are prohibited from paying players cannot be justified by anything other than a plantation mentality.
Well, you also talked, too, about the NCAA being criticized for enabling universities and corporations to make money from, as it states in the article, the unpaid labor of young athletes. And you make the point that slavery analogies should be used very carefully.
Yes, this is not slavery, but it's a lot like colonialism in that we're saying we should do this for the athletes and not pay them for their own good, which is more or less the way colonialists treated all the countries around the world that we ran. Last year, when Cam Newton was being investigated at Auburn, the NCAA specified at exactly the same time the exact size of the corporate logos for Under Armour that he had to wear on his uniform, 15 of them, four on his helmet visor, one on his headband, one on each sweatband on his wrist for Under Armour, because Under Armour had a $10.6 million deal with Auburn. So it's not very attractive. The real question is whether professionalized sports are compatible with higher education, but we're not even raising that question, which is an honest question and a real one, because we've been diverted by the notion that the big problem is dirty athletes getting some of the money. That's not the problem.
And you do lay out the academic shortcomings and shortcuts for athletes as well.